With our cross-section open at chainage 80, we're now going to make a change to the design. So we're going to remove the entire footpath section, as you can see here on the cross-section window, between chainage 0, which is at the start of our string, all the way round to chainage 170. So the footpath will be removed through those chainage ranges. To do this via the cross-section window, we hover our mouse over the code that we would like to remove, first of all, as we discussed in the introduction, making sure that when we do hover over the code, we can see it down the bottom. As we hover over LFPO, we're going to right-click. We're going to hover over Add a Variation, which is essentially what we just looked at in the design data form. Then we've got the option to add something, delete something, and change something. So insert, delete, and modify. What we want to do is to delete the footpath on the left-hand side over a chainage range of our choice. So we're going to hover over Delete Section and then click the button which says Delete Section. The form will auto-complete the majority of content for us with a chainage range. This chainage range happens to be the extent of our alignment, and it will also populate the code that we right-clicked on. In this instance, we don't want to have the entire footpath being removed all the way through, so we're going to change the last value to 170. In the design data form, if we specified chainages which were of our choosing and entirely custom, we had to click on the Add Data Entry Chainages button. This form does not require that. We can type in or pick any number of our choice, and the software will add in the sample lines for us. The code we're going to remove is the left footpath outer. We can also go and change that if we want, but in this case, that's absolutely fine. Let's click on Apply. You'll see in the drawing that the footpath has now been removed through those particular chainages, and also the cross-section. And the cross-section is a really great way of being able to see the changes that you make visually to make sure that they're happening as they should. Whilst we're on the Home tab of the cross-section window, we can open up other forms. Much like the design data form, we're able to open up the vertical grading editor. Well, in this form, we can also do the same. So it's a quick shortcut, saving us having to go via the ribbon and picking a string. We're going to open up the design data form for Road 1 by clicking on the following button. In there, you may have to expand variations. We have a variation entry which we just added via the cross-section window. All variations for the string are listed in this one dialog. You can see here the chainage range and the code. We have the option to be able to edit this entry within this part of the form if we choose. Let's close that down. In addition to using the design data form, we can also access any variations that are being applied at this particular chainage, so at chainage 80. To do that, we can right-click anywhere that you want within the cross-section window and click on the Open Section Design Data button. This form provides information about the template that's currently being applied at Road 1 at chainage 80. It also provides information about any variations that are being applied and any batter entries. If we scroll through using the little blue arrow buttons at the top, you'll see that once we get past chainage 170, the variation we've applied is no longer being displayed. This is because that variation was only told to be applied up to chainage 170, so this form will only show content at that particular cross-section. We're just going to go back to 170. We can change or remove the entry we've just added by clicking on the little delete icon, add new entries, and manage the entry as we see fit. Let's close down the section data form. Open up Model Viewer to see the changes to your design.